opening beer and opening mail. Two things that just naturally go together. This is Monarchy English Brown Ale from Little Brown Jug Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as having malt flavors of toffee, chocolate, and dark fruit. It's a very cool picture of a monarch butterfly on it, which I guess goes with the name. The first thing to fall off the pile is, well, it doesn't say what it is because it was shipped from a Canadian warehouse. Still came from a Chinese seller, I'm sure, but... Oh! It is some Spudgers! So I ordered a bunch of different Spudgers recently. Well, a few months ago, anyway. You may recall when I was trying to get into that light ballast that I just completely destroyed this one. And that goop's not going to come off, so I've just hermetically sealed it so that it doesn't cause me any problems. And last week I couldn't find this Spudger, which was the only one that I have left, and it's still got some of that goop on it too. So yeah, I ordered some more. And here is the first of those packages. This one has two different styles. It's got this little really thin one here. Qianli type D. Interesting that it has little measurements. This, I assume, is for opening phones and stuff, so you don't go too deep into it. But it's really, really thin. I'm too lazy to go and get my metric one, but it is 0.004 inch thick. You can do the conversion if you want. That's nice and flexible. That should be able to get into things, so that's kind of cool. And from the same seller, there's this little assortment called Power. There's kind of a chisel point on that end. This one's got a little fork for getting on either side of a peg or something. That one's got a little pointy nose, and that one's rounded. Now come down to a tip. And this one's got kind of a bent chisel and kind of a skewed chisel tip. And these are quite thick and solid. Yeah, that's about 70 thousandths thick. About 1.25 millimeters if this freaking thing would settle down. So that's kind of neat. Let's see how much those guys cost me. Qianli Ultra Thin Pry Opener Spudger Tools for Phone Repairing Opening Tool Kit. This one cost me 502 Canadian with free shipping. They have an assortment of different types, but I got type D. Okay, just different shapes. This came from HMT Tool. They say its color is silver, which it is, and it's made of stainless steel. Not much else to talk about in this. They don't really say anything about the measurements. Okay. And also in the same package from the same seller, three-piece universal dual metal spudger set prying scraper for tablet phone open tools. This one cost me $5.50 Canadian with free shipping. The price has changed, as you can see here. But still, not a too bad a price, I guess. Easy to use and handle, stainless steel. Be sure to exercise caution with these tools. With their great strength comes the potential to scratch or otherwise damage components that might be better served with plastic tools such... Okay, next in we have connectors. It's a single connector. This is just an odd novelty. I've been in thinking that these little Wago connectors are really slick and handy. So when I spotted this one, which is also a three-way connector, I figured I'd just get it just for a novelty. It was cheap enough. Anyway, this one is transparent, so you can see how it works a little bit. You lift up on the lever, and it just pulls that metal bit down. And then you put a wire into there. Okay, and you see that go in, and snap that down, and it grabs onto it nice and tight. Cool.
T-wire connectors, electric quick join push-in fast terminal cable wiring block. I got this at auction for 31 cents American and free shipping. Unfortunately, the listing has long expired, so there's nothing that I can show you for that. So I will link you to this search, which comes up with a bunch of random Wago style connectors. None of them are exactly the one, but There is a surprising variety of these things out there.
And the next thing in actually came from a Canadian supplier in Richmond, BC. Their address looks to me like it's down close to the airport. There's kind of an industrial area down there. So that's where it came from. Ah, it's another Spudger called the Jacomi Opener Dual Head Flexible Opening Tool. That's interesting. It's got protective covers too. They claim it'll bend up to 25 degrees. Huh. Okay, and the two tips, that one's got a 60 degree and that one's got a 50 degree on it. Okay. So there's these little safety orange tips. And that, and a sticker that fell off that side. That kind of screams quality. Oh, well, those are kind of bendy. Well, since I've got my measuring tools out, let's just see. That looks to me like about 12 thousandths thick, or about a third of a millimeter in more international measurements. Yeah, that's nice and flexible. That's a good sort of in-between. That's stiffer than the old one that I had that got all mangled and gooped up. And it's a little bit stiffer than that new thin one that I've got as well. That should be useful.
Metal blade mobile phone laptop pad repair opening pry spudger hand tool. $5.49 Canadian with free shipping from Vancouver, BC. From 2006 GNS. High quality steel blade easily slips between the tightest gaps and the toughest devices. Ergonomic handle and flexible steel blade designed to scrape or pry. Okay. Made of metal PP, polypropylene, and TPR. Not quite sure. 27 grams, 150 millimeters. Yeah, okay.
Next, we have a package from Makerfabs. You may recall that they sent me a Raspberry Pi Pico starter kit a while ago to take a look at, and that was really interesting. So they offered me something else, which is another Pi Pico starter kit, a primer kit this time. So there's the first kit that they sent me to take a look at. This one's focused on MicroPython, and it's got, you can see in there, it's got some passive infrared, some LEDs, NeoPixel ring, some resistors, the Pi Pico itself, and a breadboard, an LCD display, and a few other little components in there. A nice little kit. So let's see what this one has. So it has a Pi Pico, an expansion board for the Pi Pico, six-axis inertial measurement unit. Ooh, DHT11 temperature sensor, 10-amp relay module, a servo, slide potentiometer, a serial Wi-Fi. An ultrasonic sensor and some DuPont connectors. This may be not familiar with that. Let's take a closer look here. Ooh, nice high density foam. Nicely protected and packaged. Okay, we have a servo. Ah, this maybe is this 4-pin connector standard. The typical servo comes with a standard 3-pin connector. So this one has been modified into this maybe standard with 4 pins. Okay. So servo, slide potentiometer, again with that 4-pin connector, DHT11 temperature sensor, ESP12 and ESP8266, there is their serial to Wi-Fi, okay, that's clever. Then there is a bunch of the adapter cables. We have an ultrasonic distance sensor module. Lift that out. That'll be the inertial measurement unit that they were talking about, won't it? Yes, IMU, six axis. The bag of accessories for the servo. The relay module. Some maybe to DuPont. Wow, this is very well packaged. Can't even get my big mitts in there. There is the Pi Pico, complete with pre-soldered header pins. Very beginner friendly. And the last is this, what did they call it? the Pico expansion board, which has a place for the Pico to sit on there. I'm using the dual row headers. That way the Pico can plug into the inner row, leaving the outer row available for you to plug your own DuPont cables into. Or you can use the maybe connectors or a combination of them. And then this board has three LEDs on it, three push buttons, a little buzzer, and an LCD, a TFT LCD. So just looking at the silkscreen on the back, here is the maybe connectors. It is ground and VCC on each one, and they're all labeled as to what they're doing. That's great. So that one is TX and RX serial, SDA and SCO on that one. The other SDA and SCO on there, two analog to digital converters, a GPIO and ADC, and two GPIOs. Nice.
Raspberry Pi Pico Primer Kit from Makerfabs. They're selling it for $34.80, and they tell me that they're going to be sending me a discount code for this. I will put the link in that code if I receive it before publishing down in the description. Okay, so they've got a video here with a little bit of a starter guide on that, and there's this link as well for documentation. That takes you to their blog and shows you how to get some image display happening right away. That's nice. There's the hardware pins that are being used for the display. Okay. So the Pi Pico can be used either with Arduino C code or, if you prefer, MicroPython. The other kit focused a bit more on MicroPython. This one, it looks like it's focusing more on Arduino. What else have they got on their webpage here? Oh, they have a wiki link too. Okay. Yeah, okay, they've got a bunch of different projects linked in their wiki. Excellent. Okay. So yeah, I'll link to this page and it has the links to all the other documentation. That is slick.
That is a very beginner-friendly looking kit. I'm looking forward to playing with that a little bit. And because this mailbag didn't have enough stuff in it, I got a package from Dustin Watts. You may know him as a Dutch electronics YouTuber, and he has, in the last little while, been focused on developing a product. This is Dustin's ESP32 TouchDown, which, as you can see, features an ESP32 TFT screen with capacitive touch, battery management, USB to UART, micro SD card holder, buzzer, many, many things. If you want to find out more about it, there's one way of doing it right there. That is impressive packaging, especially for somebody who's like a one-man show. That's pretty good. So here is the main event. So from the front, it's just a TFT touchscreen. And the back is where all the magic is happening here. So we have the ESP32, we have the GPIO pins, we have the passive buzzer, SD card, connector, two connectors going up to the screen, one of them display and one of them touch screen, USB, a stemma connector, power to a battery, charging, and a switch, USB UART, okay, very complete little device, and then a boot and reset button over there. So without doing any reading or going to the website or anything, I'm just going to plug it into USB and see what happens. Ha ha ha. So I haven't really explained what this thing is yet. Have you heard of the Touchdeck? Yeah, this is basically Dustin's version of that. So each of these buttons goes to different functions. I don't have it connected to the computer. I'm just connected right now to power. So like anything with the software run, it's probably a good idea to go and find some documentation, which I shall do.
So here are some of the features, which is basically what we saw already. It is programmable using the Arduino IDE or Platform IO, or running the free TouchDeck software. It's fully open source. You can do any modifications or whatever you want to it, or you can just run the software that Dustin provides on it, which is that free TouchDeck. Available in various different places. Cool. How much is he? Let's just try Tindy here. Okay, so it's $59 US plus shipping, depending on where in the world you want it. Designed by Dustin Watts in the Netherlands. And here's a link to Dustin's GitHub with all the software. This is the software that ships on it right now. Oh, hey, cases on Thingiverse for it. That's useful. Looks like there's a bunch of different cases here. The one that Dustin made, plus a bunch of ones that other people have made. Oh, that's excellent. I have some options to explore. So I'm going to link you both to the ESP32 Touchdown webpage, but also to Dustin's YouTube channel, which has a bunch of videos about the whole process that he went through to design and build this thing. And he talks about software and all manner of other stuff on here. So, yeah, definitely go check him out.
Well, that was a mailbag full of fun and goodness, wasn't it? Quickly go over the shipping times from China because people seem interested in that. This set of Spudgers took 14 days, but it came from a Canadian drop shipping warehouse. This other Spudger only took 10 days from Vancouver. This little 30-cent wonder took 46 days to get here from China. Wow. And then these, I think that took a couple of weeks to get to Canada from the Netherlands. And this, well, they shipped a DHL, so it only took a couple of days to get here. Anyway, yeah, this is going to be fun to play with. I'm not sure if I want to use this with their experiments or demonstrations, or if I want to go in my own direction with this. I've got some ideas, I'm not sure. But that one and this one are both pretty good kits that Makerfabs puts together. I think I can recommend them. Just for the hardware in them alone, I think it's worth the money. And Dustin's project, I've been following him on YouTube, like I said, and that is a really slick little project. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to use it. Well, I probably will use it with the free TouchDeck software that it comes loaded with. I'll just have to configure it, which means I'm going to have to go to his YouTube channel and go through his configuration explanations. As I recall from previously watching them, they're fairly straightforward, so it shouldn't be that hard to configure it up. And then I'll print a box for it, of course. Not sure what I'm going to use it for yet. I might use it just on my main computer just for shortcuts, like it shows, to web browsing and email and YouTube. Or I might use it with OBS on my my workshop computer here for when I'm recording, just to start and stop recordings and jump to different things. I'm not sure yet. I'll have to play with that in the future. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate that as always. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for buying me beer and keeping some of these mailbag items rolling in. Thanks to Makerfabs, link down in the description. Thanks to Dustin, and again, link to his stuff down in the description. What an embarrassment of riches. Thanks, everybody. I will talk to you later. Comments and questions? Yeah, you know that. Okay, talk to you. Bye.